Right here in today's video, we're going to help unlicensed or non-licensed practitioners understand how prohibitions against unlicensed practice of medicine might or might not constrain their services or facilitate them. Hi, I'm Michael H. Cohen, founding attorney of Cohen Healthcare Law Group, and we help healthcare industry clients just like you navigate the legal terrain for health and wellness services and products. That's what we do. All right. So Ava has a PhD in psychology, but she's decided not to get her licensed as a clinical psychologist because she wants to offer somatic therapy, body work with some behavioral health component, and in her eyes, not be subject to all the restrictions and risks from a regulatory board. Is Ava making the right choice, or is she actually increasing her legal and regulatory exposure? Like many clients, Ava heard it from someone who heard it from someone else, whose brother's cousin's friend, sister-in-law, consulted a lawyer. And that lawyer said, okay, we know this rabbit hole. Don't trust it. In California, it's true. Like, non-licensed practitioners are on safer legal ground because of California Business and Professions Code 2053.5, the legal safe harbor for the unlicensed. The statute says the non-licensee should disclose to the client in writing that they're not a physician, say that their services are alternative or complementary to those offered by licensed persons, and make a bunch of other disclosures about their training, qualifications, and methods. A key point here is that those services, though, cannot be unlawful and cannot constitute the practice of medicine. So the statute's a bit of a circle in that it exempts non-licensees from the prohibition, yet it then goes ahead and references unlicensed practice of medicine. Caution, discretion, judgment, strategy are advised. Now, if Ava's offering psychological counseling, or if what she does could in any way be construed or even misconstrued by board as unlicensed practice of psychology or behavioral health, then she would be at risk. A lot depends exactly on what she does and how she describes her markets or healthcare coaching services. Some clients are better off working within their license and abiding by the rules of the profession and regulatory board so that they're not at risk of unlicensed practice, paradoxically enough. In a state like California, where there's somewhat of a legal umbrella, some clients do better operating under an SB 577, the kind of statute that's codified that we mentioned earlier. Thanks for watching. Please contact us with your questions. We've helped hundreds and hundreds, thousands, if not thousands, of healthcare clients just like you, practitioners to ventures, everything in between. And we look forward to working with you on your journey to success.